Hola.
Hola. Hola.
I'm Scott Helms. I'm the artistic director of Desert Overture in Phoenix. We are currently in the middle of our fifth season, which is pretty exciting for us. And in those few short years that we have existed, we've learned a few things that work for us. So I thought I'd share some of those with you. Like your bands, we have a mission statement, and it can basically be boiled down into two basic things we do through our music. One is supporting our members, and the other is supporting our community. So first, I'm going to tell you about some of the ways that we support our members. Like many other bands, we charge dues to our members. New members who haven't played in years aren't sure always that they want to contribute money to something that they're not sure that they can even do because it's been so long since they played, or if it's going to be enjoyable. So what we did to help ease the initial financial burden is we created a scholarship program. It started with a $1,000 donation from a member, and others can contribute to that fund. All new members get their first season's dues paid by the scholarship fund. This helps the new people try the band out and become hooked on band before they have a big financial commitment. The organization doesn't lose dues income because it's covered by the scholarship fund, so it's a win-win. We also support our members with team leaders. These are not section leaders. They don't really have any musical role. They do some administrative things like keep attendance records and check in with members who have missed several rehearsals. They also help us find volunteers to load the equipment truck and staff the Pride Festival booth. But more importantly, they help team members feel connected socially by throwing parties, potlucks, and social events. It helps the members feel part of the band family. They send cards or flowers for significant life events, and it keeps our members feeling connected and happy. It helps to pull more shy or newer members into the social fabric of the band. That one's not showing. We stumbled upon another way to support members by accident. Because we were a new band, no money for rehearsal space or music, we needed to perform, so we did our first public performance called A La Carte. It was a concert of solos and small chamber ensembles. We didn't think about how this could benefit our members until later, but some people wanted to take a break from band in the summer, and others wanted to keep playing the year round. So A La Carte is at the end of the summer, and those who want to play sign up, and those who don't want to can opt out. It's become an annual tradition. It builds musicianship for the full band, and it gives us an opportunity to showcase individual talent. It also allows multi-talented members to play secondary instruments that they don't get the chance to, like piano or recorder. So far, we've talked about supporting our members by waiving a new member's dues with a scholarship, giving members flexibility with the A La Carte concert, and having team leaders to help members feel connected. Now let's talk about some of the ways Desert Overture supports our community. In 2012, all Phoenix LGBT music organizations came together for a combined concert called We Are One. The concert featured the Arizona Women in Tune, Voices of the Desert Mixed Chorus, the Phoenix Metropolitan Men's Chorus, and Desert Overture. This has now become a biannual event. Each group performed a short set individually, and then all 200 musicians gathered on stage to perform together with Desert Overture accompanying the mass choir. Each of the conductors from the four ensembles led one piece with the combined groups. Each group drew its own audience, and as a result, people were being introduced to ensembles that they had never heard before. The members of the separate ensembles got to know each other better in rehearsals, fostering a more supportive atmosphere among the various groups. Another way we support our community is through our charity partnership program. Band members nominate charities that they would like to support. From among the nominations, the band votes on three charities to support with our three major concerts. In this partnership, we donate a percentage of our ticket sales with a guaranteed minimum to the charity. In exchange, they help to promote our concert and provide a speaker to give a brief talk about their organization at the concert. Since starting the charity partnership program last season, we have given financial support to 1 in 10 GLBT Youth Center, the American Heart Association, Phoenix Children's Hospital, and Tumbleweed Center for Youth Development. At our children's concert, in addition to supporting the Phoenix Children's Hospital financially, we held a stuffed animal drive. As we played Children's March by Granger, the kids paraded their stuffed animals around the auditorium, ending on the stage where they donated the animals to the hospital. It was a very powerful thing to see. These are some of the ways that we have successfully supported our members and our community. If you'd like details about any of these programs, you can always email me at director@desertoverture.org. Thank you.